Cutie Pies, very warm welcome to you. I just want to start off by saying, Windows, you are out. I am unfriending Windows for restarting on me after recording a video for you. I will still accept doors, roofs, floors, and of course, water taps for kindness and friendship. At the beginning of September, we summoned a green September. There are some very bizarre things that go on, especially when it comes to positioning and markets. How everybody is positioned is most important. That is actually the most secret ingredient to understanding markets themselves. Yes, there is a secret, and it's called positioning. Friends, there are a lot of bizarre things that happens in the minds of humans and markets. Bizarre objects in the universe. And of course, we are trying to completely eradicate our friendship with the red monthly candle of September. Six freaking red Septembers in a row. But now we have a fighting chance. Hello, hello, look at you. We hope this continues and we hope nothing disturbs the force. And here I am here. Look, we're hanging on by a fine line. I'm done with September, just to let you guys know. And girls and squirrels and ducks. I have a calendar notification for September for next year as well. Every year for the next 10 years, just telling me, remember, September's trash. That's how much PTSD we have from garbage September. So I say, no mercy, finish him. And I'd like to remind you that the candles are mostly red before they turn green. Have a look at this beautiful duck video.
Every week you see them swim, and you cry.
I mean, it's so emotional. Duxu, always there for us. And speaking of always being there, do you remember a man named BitBoy? Will always be BitBoy to us. Ben Armstrong shows us the power of network effects. Friends, you got to really understand what I'm about to tell you, all right? Because, like, everyone just sees a Bitcoin chart. I see a story. I'm going to tell you something. At the beginning of Bitcoin's life, the network effect was so small that if you just added 100,000 people and then 1 million and then 10 million, you got a parabolic price pump. So there was demand that they took for granted. They took Bitcoin going up for granted. Plan B had his stock with flow model, right? It wasn't made back then, but you get the impression everybody just saw this as something that was just always happening. You know, Bitcoin's green candles turned everybody into a believer. But what happened after that? What happened after that was, now that everybody took Bitcoin as just like a number go up thing that kept happening, we started focusing on supply. You understand? Okay, there's demand and there is supply. Not enough people in crypto focus on the demand side. Make sure you like, subscribe, press the bell button and all. I go through this in my very, very early video. So many times I went through this to tell you there's demand and supply. Most crypto people, because they're involved in tech and they have pens that go in their front pockets and their checkered shirts, they focus on supply. Why? Because the supply can be modified with code. Supply we can control. Us. Me and you. Very hard to control demand, but demand is what actually makes things go up. Demand is the most important factor in all of crypto. Not enough entrepreneurs in crypto or crypto dApps, decentralized applications, focus on demand. They don't. It's all about the end user. The product must cater to what the consumers want. You might say, well, consumers want the price to go up. Yes, but you need something else, man. You need something else. You need things out there. Like, for example, you need a story, okay? You need a campaign. You need entertainment. This is all network effect stuff. Network effect, okay? This is what you actually need, okay? You need this stuff. Family. That's why I say things like cult. You need a cult. What's a cult? The cult is the residual demand that people will have, the fundamental value people will have. Once the price goes down minus 99%, they're still there. That's how you can increase your probability of it going up again. Remember, it's not a guarantee. You just increase the probability. Why? It's because in the cult, it means everybody's sticky. Everybody's stuck together. Everybody's holding hands. So when money flows around and comes back, hey, you've got a group of 100,000, 200,000, 30,000 people in the cult, however big it is, they can make some noise. And as people return back to crypto and they start feeling more confident again, you get to pocket some of that demand, which is people coming in. People want a place to go. They want something to believe in. That's why you always hear me take on Gary Guzler, the semen demon himself, trying to chug all that semen for himself. I'm here to take on a boss. I'm always David versus Goliath. Swami is your friend, David. I'm always taking on Goliath. Other people like to fight with themselves. That's okay. Fighting and drama. It generates demand. You need that. But in the early Bitcoin days, they took that demand for granted. Now they just focus on supply. So where does that lead us to? BitBoy is going to show you how it's done. BitBoy, if you're listening out there, Benny Boy is a friend of this channel. He's a friend of PulseChain. He said very nice things about Richard Hart. He's friends with Richard Hart. They went to a game together. They hung out together. Just want you to know, this is super important. When people have their back against the wall, if you can reach out your hand and say, you know what? We support you. But you know what's funny? We're also down 99%. So that actually makes us bigger men and women. We're actually more family people because of that. We are stronger because you can do that. You can actually bring people in. You go, hey, we are in a moment of weakness, but we're still here to help you. You know, there's many Bible stories of people out here. There's many parables out there you can learn. I remember there was a story from Jesus. There was like a lady. She gave like 2 pennies. She was like so poor. She gave 2 pennies for a donation. And he basically told everybody that, you know, this woman had nothing to her name. She just had 2 little like copper coins. That's all she had. And she's given more than everybody else. You got to learn from these stories out there, friends. Okay, you don't have to like be a super believer in anything. I'm just telling you. These are the moments that define you. This is how character gets built. And then this is like synergy and it snowballs. This is how you actually go and make something big. No one's looking at Litecoin, all right? No one's looking at any of these other dead coins. No one cares about them. Stellar, all right? Vegan XRP. No one cares about them. There's no story there. There's no conflict. You need these to happen. So BitBoy, obviously, is going through that battle with the BitBoy office, okay? They're renamed to Discover Crypto. But something's going on here, friends. So, yeah, I've reached out to BitBoy. I think a synergy can be made here, just so he knows. He doesn't have to come. I'm not telling him to rename to PulseBoy. By the way, shout out to the gentleman who told us to do this, made this meme for me. I think it was Mr. Rob Brown. So, PulseBoy, isn't that funny? So, look at this, just throwing this stuff out there. It's cool and it sticks. But you got to understand, it's all about the network effects, friends. You got to think about, remember I just told you, demand and supply. You got to focus on the demand. What do people want? You say, yeah, okay, they want price to go up. Okay, duh, everyone wants price to go up. They actually want something more. They want to belong somewhere. People want to belong somewhere. It's financial entertainment, you know? There are guys, girls, squirrels, and ducks. They want to gamble with their friends. They want to believe in something. They want to have a long-term vision. They want something to believe in. They want something to believe in. So if Ben Boy is listening out there. Okay, so yes, everybody's abandoned you. Just want you to know, we didn't. And when I say we, just letting you know, you go into lookintohex.com, fantastic website built by a community member, Gerardo. You can actually see, look at this. This is just the hex numbers here. There are 159,000 total hex stakers. I think it's about 200,000 unique holders. 200,000 people, fanatical, strong core. Now, this isn't like, you know, a million people just flimsy and flamsy who maybe pay attention to crypto. No, this is different. This is a cult or a guild or a very, very strong family. This is super important. Just let you know, you don't have to do anything. You don't have to rename or get a pulse chain tattoo or hex. No one wants you to do any of that, man. Just remain yourself. You just got to remember this community is here. That's it. Just remember we're here. That's actually all you need, friends. Trust me. And I mentioned in here, I want you to remember something, okay? So if Ben's listening, my favorite debate of BitBoy Ben was when he went on Anthony Pompliano's show. And I have the clip here for you now, friends, because everyone expected BitBoy to just be like waffling around like a fish and flopping around and not say anything. And then he came out with this, like full attack mode, and stood his ground.
And yesterday you were saying, like, we just go and we say, you know, go buy this and we sell bags. Never in the history of this channel have I done that. Not one time. Not one single time have I ever done that. And the stuff and the words that come out of your mouth, that buy into the meme culture, in the echo chamber that you live in, it's asinine, Pump. It really, you're out here assassinating people's characters. All I said was, I didn't agree with the way that you worded that video. That's literally all I said, and it's led to all this. It's ridiculous, to be honest with you.
Well, because again, Here's how a free market works. You're free to say whatever you want. But when you say dumb shit, like Dogecoin's going to $5, and you also put up stuff that's saying XRP is going to $589, and you also say don't buy Bitcoin.
You're the one saying Bitcoin is going to 20 million, Pomp.
Hold on. No, see, that's a lie.
There you go, friends. It's actually true. It was actually true. This is the perfect example. Everything, all of my videos, they all come down to something like a clip like this, just a gem to share with you. Everyone is shitting their bags. They just use different words. It's a game. It's a game. There's 420 million people in crypto right now. Maybe the next billion that come in aren't going to allocate the way we think they're going to allocate. So, well, me and you, we're in a secret club, right? We understand they're not going to allocate fully to Bitcoin. All the Bitcoin people genuinely believe, yes, Bitcoin dominance going to 99%. Bitcoin's going to get a $700,000 because fix the money, fix the world. They genuinely believe that. But what do we know? We know people like playing with their PP. We know people like hexagons. We know people just want to buy altcoins. We want people buy into memes and casinos and all this other stuff. We know people like buying JPEGs. I know they're not cool right now. Gaming, metaverse, layer ones. They're here to belong to a community. They want to throw stuff around. We know people are going to allocate differently to what those blue chippers expect. So that's why I'm just saying. BitBoy, controversial. Yes, he's been through a lot. But you got to learn something, friends. There's a network effect to go off here. That's why like, there's a bell curve, right? There's a bell curve, okay? Now, example I can use. What about the dentist industry? Okay, let's do a tooth for dentist. I got no idea. If you put a coconut in my mouth, I wouldn't know what the hell's going on. I know Mr. Crypto Sloth. He's in the dentist industry. I got no idea. You and me, most of us, we're in the middle of the bell curve, okay? So do you know any dentists? No, but if some popular dentist came out and started like being really cool and marketing stuff or just being loud, that's the only person we're going to know. We're literally retailers in the dentist industry. I just took this random industry. Do you see what I mean? But Mr. Sloth would be like, no, this is what you should eat. This is how you should treat your health. He knows everything because he's studying it like 50,000 hours a day. We got no idea. This is so important. In crypto, everybody's in the middle, man. We're here 18 hours a day. I'm here providing you information. Other people out there don't care. They don't care. Why do you think it's going this way? It's because people are here for different reasons. The narratives that me and you think people care about, they don't actually care about, you know? What were the early Bitcoin narratives, friends, here? Bitcoin was FU money. Bitcoin was a better money system. Bitcoin was trying to fix the money, fix the world. That comes later. At the start, it was just, I don't care, magic internet money, let's go in, right? Then Ethereum came in. Then you literally have John McAfee saying, I'm going to eat my willy because of Bitcoin's mathematics and the supply cutting off. Now you have Michael Saylor, cybernetic hornet's nest, New York real estate. Now you have that type of stuff. Now you have Elon Musk going, I like it. Now I don't like it. Now whatever. Right? This is late majority. This is laggards. Now you have Roca Negra, BlackBerry, the spot ETF coming in to shield to the final exit pump people. You see, the narratives have changed along the world. That's why I want you to just pay attention, okay? Pay attention to how BitBoy tries to rebuild again. I want you to know, when it comes to this, if you want to do self-branding, marketing, friends, yes, you can do that as well. But you don't have to, because we just got to understand, we've got to get into the mindset of demand. Got to get into the mindset of what people want. Because everyone is going to try invest from the future based off the past. That's how they're going to get it wrong. They're going to think, okay, fix the money, fix the world. They're probably going to see record money printing, and they're probably going to think Bitcoin's going to go to a record high new price, and it might even not. You see, you got to be careful, because Bitcoin's network effect is based off the number of people who think that the US dollar might collapse. And if that gets turned on and off, it might not go the way you think. It's all about these stories and network effects, friends. We got to start focusing on the demand side, not the supply side. So there you go. I think BitBoy, friend of the community, it's going to be very interesting to see how he rebuilds. He always has a home on Pulse Chain. Don't forget, you don't need to do anything with the coins. Doesn't really matter. When the whirlwind starts, we all know what's up. It's going to be about who has the loudest megaphone. And that's why, friends, when you're a cult or a guild, you are a unified voice. 200,000 people saying the same things. That's way better than what my neighbor who's dealing with Litecoin is going to have. Make sure you like, subscribe, bell button, and all. I'm going to catch you in the next one.